Today we are going to talk about CBA rules for pay overrides that apply to red-eye flights, international flights requiring a special airport qualification, or SAQ, non-domestic flights, which are not identified as SAQ flight segments, and ETOPS flights. Section 4FF lists the override percentages and how they apply. As an example, using these contractual rules, if you were to fly an ETOPS leg with a straight pay value of 5 TFP, the 5% override of 0.25 TFP will result in the flight paying a total of 5.25 TFP. Remember that overrides can stack on top of each other. So for example, if the same ETOPS flight happened to operate as a red eye at any time between 0100 to 0400 domicile time, then an additional 3% override is applied to the straight pay value of 5 TFP and will result in the flight paying a total of 5.4 TFP. Also notice that for deadhead pay, the only applicable override is for red eye flight segments. All other deadheads are excluded from overrides. Note that when you do earn an override, it is paid above all other credit for the pairing. It cannot be swallowed up by any rig. Note that on the payroll report, it appears separate and below the rest of the TFP for the pairing. Note also that paragraph 4 stipulates that the overrides will not be paid on non-fly events such as vacation, sick leave, training pools, and fatigue. In other words, the flight must be flown for the applicable override to apply. If the flight gets canceled or you're reassigned and don't actually perform that flight or deadhead, you do not get paid the override. And to reiterate, overrides will be calculated based only on the straight time value of the leg flown, even if the pairing was awarded at premium or junior assigned at double time.